Okay, so we have this wall. It's the old plumbing. We need to still take that vent pipe out, change it to PVC or whatever. This will be the laundry room. Need to build a wall here-ish to do that. Maybe move this wall here, 10 feet in, so it'll give us a little more clearance for the counter space. Vanity, toilet, and then tub right over here where the light is.
This is the laundry room. We had to do a pan for the dryer and the washer, with of course a P-trap on it. Then we had to have a separate water supply for the dryer because it's fancy, it has steam. Then we have our washer, still gotta run this. This is our in the wall vent pipe, which we need to finish this weekend. Moves into a sub panel, the whole upstairs, or at least the whole upstairs addition, possible expansion. And then into the new bathroom. It's a 5-piece, classic. And it's toilet, shower, bath, and 2 sinks. This is the biggest, smallest 5-piece ever. This is our tub, claw-footed. Claw-foot's not on. Those little buggers over there are causing us problems, the sinks. This is the sunk-in shower right here.
Why is it sunk in?
Because it's going to be flush, hopefully, after it gets tiled. So that slope, it's a tiny slope, but that slope hopefully will be enough to drag it into the drain. This back here will be a storage or walkway back to service. The vent pipe's back there. There'll be a secret passage door over here. This will be, I don't know. Michelle hasn't told me yet. And this is where the vanities are. There's 2 sinks with the mirrors and lights.
Well, we're measuring here is 13 1/4. This side, make sure that we're laying at 13 1/4. This side looks good. Ready for your pull saw thing when you're ready. Let's check out the upstairs bathroom and see how it turned out after we finished it up. Just to remind you guys how it looked beforehand, originally there was nothing back here. There had been a small closet area. It was originally the closet for the bedroom, which is behind Josh right now in the camera. But behind that, there was literally nothing, just 2x4s to support the ceiling below, but not even like sufficient joists to create a floor. So pretty much everything back here, you know, we built and put in. Spent a lot of time designing it, kind of reconfiguring the space to make sure we could fit everything in, follow the codes, etc., etc. Here we've got our double vanity. Got a lot of different lighting options. Great for putting your makeup on, which I really like. A built-in, like, you know, space to hold your linens and stuff like that, so that's been really good. Behind here is a crawl space access, so you can get behind the bathroom, access some of the plumbing if you ever need to, hopefully no one ever needs to. Behind here, we've got a thermostat. This room has its own, like, heat setting, because everybody, if you're like me, you want an extra toasty warm bathroom. So we've got a radiator in here, and we can set, if we want this setting a little bit higher than the other rooms, so we can come here and take your showers and some warm. As you can see, we put the shower in the middle of the room. Some logistical issues there in terms of keeping the splashing down. Everything's waterproof, because we were planning for that, but at the same time, you don't have to clean up a giant wet mess every time. So just recently, we installed this bar, so now you can have a shower curtain, which is pretty great. And then the bathtub, we haven't used yet, and I don't know that we will so much. I think everybody wants a bathtub, but how often do you actually use it? Yeah, it's all right.
I mean, the tile was hard to do, of course. Well, just not hard, but just a lot of it, since it was on all the walls, all the floors.
Yeah, and I don't know if we showed in the original video, but what we had to do as we were putting in the plywood subfloor, we actually had to, like, drop that subfloor for the shower pan area so that when we did get to the tiling, it would all flow kind of pretty seamless for what we were going for.
So those diagonal lines are just where the drain goes to?
Yeah. But it works surprisingly well. I mean, the slope is just right that the water pours down, so. Yeah, another thing we want to talk about was the skylights that we put in here. This was a perfectly good functioning roof, but you know, sometimes you just need to cut a couple holes in it. Actually, that was kind of terrifying, right?
Definitely.
Yeah, we didn't have experience with roof tiling or anything like that. Luckily, we were able to find a match for the tile at Lowe's, so that worked out really well. Did one that opens, one that's fixed, and that'll be good for this area. Otherwise, it would have been pretty dark in here, and also it would just help with the cross flow when we turn the whole house fan on, just to bring the cool air in during the summertime.
I listen to the wind of my soul. Where I'll end up, well, I think only God really knows. I've sat upon the setting sun, but never, 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 never. I never wanted water once. Never, never, never. I listen to my words, but they fall far below. I let my music take me where my heart wants to go. I've swam upon the devil's lake, but never, 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 never. I'll never make the same mistake. No, never, never,
see it?
Never.
This is the upstairs bathroom.
Yeah.
2020, the day before our anniversary, 6 years. Okay, go.
Very good.
This is when it overflows?
Yeah.